Today we have almost reached to the 15th session of spoken English, free spoken English class. Students across the country from various states have been participating in these classes. The main thrust area in this context is we would like to enhance your communication skills. So many people, irrespective of the gender, status, cadre, and educational qualifications, do need English language speaking skills. Of course, they do need writing skills too. But primarily, speaking skills top the position as people have to interact to get things done. It has become a very common phenomenally. Let me welcome all of you friends. We are about to have this feast of words in English language. My teacher used to tell us when we were in the class, the best thing for learning English is your appetite to practice. Please have it. I do believe your appetite to just taste English, smell it, eat it, digest it, it will be yours. With this positive note, let me welcome you all for this session. Good evening once again to all of you. Would you be able to check what is there in the store for us? Grammar and usage, present continuous tense. One sentence has been done for you. The boys are playing football. So, can we make sentences? The boys, verb is sing, a movie. Playing. These are the three clues with which you can make. In the meanwhile, please write down in your notebooks. I'll get back to you. Four sentences. Just we are going to make four sentences. My mother read the newspaper. My father watch TV. My friend do a crossword puzzle. Yes. The example in red color, the sentence shows subject comes first, next helping verb is used, afterwards we add ing form to the main verb. It could be play, it could be sing or read or watch or do. So ing is added to it, an object comes afterwards, and at the end of the sentence we will keep full stop. This is the idea. Friends, please try making, you know, meaningful sentences with the help of these clues. I'll give you absolutely 1 minute, not less than that. Your time starts now.
The boys are singing a devotional songs.
Object song or songs?
Songs.
Can you read the sentence once again, ma'am?
The boys are singing a devotional songs.
Good. There is a small correction. The boys are singing, it's absolutely okay. There is no problem.
Yeah,
devotional songs. Songs is object.
Yes.
Yeah. Devotional is adjective. This is in plural context. This is a plural form. Yes. So you cannot use in front of
correct.
Devotional.
Yes. Yes.
The boys are singing
devotional songs.
That's it. You can eliminate that word. Thank you, ma'am.
Yes. Okay.
Second one. Let me ask this. Bhamadev Babu.
My mother is reading newspaper.
Can you please read slowly, sir? Loudly.
My mother is reading newspaper.
Already THE, that's an article. The is there. Did you use A? Before newspaper, did you use A?
Okay.
Yes.
You don't have to use A. Already article is there. My mother
is reading a newspaper.
The. No need to keep A there. Already article is there, sir. Something that is there in her hands. So, the is used there. My mother is reading the newspaper. Enough. Okay. Thanks.
Okay. Thank you.
Charita.
Sir, one more time. Can you please tell that one?
Which one, sir?
Just now you told my mother is reading the newspaper. That's all, no?
Yes, my mother is reading the newspaper. Why should we use this newspaper?
Okay.
The newspaper in her hands is the only one. We are talking about that. That is why we need to use the. The is used for something to denote specifically.
Okay, right. Yes.
For example, there is a road. We are on A side, but there are some boys on the B side. All boys have worn violet colored dress, but one boy particularly, you know, was on yellow colored dress. You want to tell us that yellow colored dress boy, the one who has worn yellow colored dress, is an intelligent boy. I am asking you, Bhamadev, can you please show me who is intelligent among those boys? We are on this side of the road and the boys are on the other side. Then you are asking all of us, Uma ma'am, Charita, Durga, Nihar, come here, I will show you. See, can you see the boy on yellow color clad, the boy, why do you say the boy here? There are many boys. But when you specify something, then you the boy on that clad. Thank you. Charita?
Watching TV.
My father is watching TV. Good. Next. Nihar?
My friend is doing a crossword puzzle.
My friend?
He is doing a crossword puzzle.
He is doing a crossword puzzle. Very good. Thank you very much. Verbs. This is the topic. Write V2 and V3 forms. Write V2 and V3 forms. Will you be able to do that? Okay, let me give you 2 minutes time for that. In 2 minutes, we'll get back to discuss this. Okay.
Heard. Had. No, you, no.
Okay, ma'am, thank you. Next, Bhamadev Babu.
Okay.
Prakash.
Heard.
Turn on video. Say it loudly.
Heard.
Here is the first form. Already it is there. Second form is heard. What is the spelling heard. For heard?
Yeah, R-D, sir.
H-E-R-D. Heard. Did you write like that?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Some of us do say H-E-R-D as heard. Because V1 form is here, we think it is heard. But it's not heard. It's heard. And third form is also heard. Please make sure you just say from now on heard and heard. Thank you, Prakash. Next two. Srikanth Mishraji. Please give us the next two words.
Okay. Have, had, no, new, known.
Have, had, no is the form. New, K-N-E-W, new, and K-N-O-W, known is the third form. Past participle. Thank you very much. Next. Charita.
Wanted.
Wished. Nihar. Can you please tell us the next word? Next, last word is believe. Just believe.
Believed.
Okay. Coming to this first one, friends, it's ma'am said, am is or, but third form is not or. First form in the sense, according to tense, be is the first, if it is, am is or. Second form is, it was or.
Was.
Third form will be, been, B-E-N, been. Okay. Madam, please write it down. Be.
Yes, sir.
So we use in present context, am is or. Second past context, we use was and were. Was is for singular, were is for plural. And future context, in the third form context, past participle of the be is been. Here becomes heard, have, had, no, new, known, wanted, wish, wished, believed. Now I'll give you 1 minute. Read all these 7 words and you have to tell me here. Your time starts now. Practice.
Second form was, were, and third form been. Here, heard, heard, have, had, had, known, knew, known, want, wanted, wanted, wish, wished, wished, believe, believed, believed.
Thank you very much. Charita?
Be was were, been, hear, heard, heard, known, knew, known, have, had.
Here, chudu, akada. Here, heard, ankodudu. We should not say heard. Then, man, ela pronounce cheyali, V2, V3 forms heard.
Heard, heard.
Yeah. Here, heard, heard.
Wish, wished, wished. Believe, believed, believed. Want, wanted, wanted. Known, knew, known. That's
fantastic. Thank you very much. Uma, ma'am. Go to you, ma'am. Ma'am's network problem. When will you buy? Maybe after 2 months. So I think you can find it truly interesting. I'll give you absolutely 1 minute. Please, friends, practice, take the screenshot, practice, and get back to me. Your times?
Well, I can't.
Why?
It's too expensive, ma'am.
When will you buy?
Maybe after 2 months.
Reverse conversation.
Will you buy this jewelry, ma'am?
Well, I can't.
Why?
It is too expensive.
When will you buy?
Maybe after 3 months.
Okay, ma'am.
Durga Kishore Bhamadev.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Will you buy this jewelry?
Well, I can't.
Why?
It's too expensive.
When will you buy it then?
So maybe after 2 months.
Okay.
Will you buy this jewelry?
Well, I can't.
Why?
It's too expensive.
When will buy? When will you buy?
Maybe after 2 months.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Charita Nihar.
Sir. Sir, sorry for disturb you.
Instead of saying it's too expensive for me, you can say, I can't afford. A-F-F-O-R-D.
Right.
I can't afford. When you are not capable of buying anything,
yes,
you might probably say affordable. The word is suitable in any context, be it buying a small pet dog or furniture, AC, anything. I cannot afford. Otherwise, it's too expensive. These expressions can be used. Did you get Bhamadev?
Yes, sir. Yes,
okay. Okay, good. Nice point. Next, Nihar and Charita.
Hi, Charita.
Hi, ma'am. Will you buy this jewelry?
Well, I can't afford it.
Why?
It is too expensive.
When will you buy?
Maybe after 2 months.
Oh.
Will you buy this jewelry?
Well, I can't.
Why?
It's too expensive.
When will you buy this?
Maybe after 2 months.
Okay, thank you.
Charita Bhamadev. Srikant Mishra ji.
Charita, will you buy this jewelry?
Well, I can't.
Why?
It's too expensive.
And when will you buy?
Maybe after 2 months.
Okay.
Sir, will you buy this jewelry?
Well, I can't.
Why?
It's too expensive.
When will you buy?
Maybe after 2 months.
Fantastic. Good. You can add a few more sentences to stretch the conversation. Why should you have to stick to the one which I have provided? You can still expand the conversation with beautiful thoughts, you know.
Okay.
Language is an art. Please don't confine to the tailor-made expressions. So these are just to give you kind of, you know, scaffolding. So with the help of these sentences and phrases, think over various possibilities of making sentences in that particular context and enlarge your, you know, potential skills to speak English. Now, Durga Prakash and Uma ma'am.
Hi, Durga.
Hi, ma'am.
Will you buy this jewelry?
Well, I can't.
Why?
Very costly.
When will you buy?
Maybe after 2 months. Will you buy this jewelry, ma'am?
No, I can't.
But why?
It is too expensive.
When will you buy it then?
Maybe after 2 months.
Okay. Thank you.
Now, we are entering a creative zone, a small change. This conversation is the base for you. Now you are not going to take a look at your books because you have already held a pen in your hands and book is there, you are writing. And somehow, since the book is very close by, so I can guess while you are still looking at us, the eyes are blinking down. We don't feel much confidence. So simply we just take a look at this and then we do. It's only the case with people who have turned on videos. But the smartest guys in this session are those who have not turned on during the presentation. Simply they have turned off the video and I do not know whether they are just watching or just casually speaking. So friends, please stretch the conversation. You are going to do that. Stretch the conversation for 1 minute. Now, Mishra ji and Uma ma'am, use this conversation, keep going the conversation little further. Your time starts now.
Okay. Uma ma'am?
Yes, Mishra ji.
Will you buy this precious jewelry?
No, I can't.
Actually,
I heard. Other shop, they give cheap than this shop.
Yeah, you are saying the right thing, ma'am. But I think this jewelry is different from their jewelry because this is a branded jewelry, and the shops who are selling this jewelry in the lowest cost, lower cost, that is not a brand, and you can lose your rupees by buying those jewelry. So buy this because this is branded. And you can ask about your neighbor also. Your neighbor, Shrimati Anita Mishra ji, she has also bought this jewelry and she is using this jewelry from the last 3 years. And there is no kind of any scratch or any other deformation to this jewelry. Please ask from her.
Last 10 seconds.
When will you buy, ma'am, this? Will you buy this, ma'am?
Maybe after 2 months, I think.
Okay, decision is yours, ma'am, but buy it now because there is a rebate at this time. So if you buy at this time, you can get 25%.
Time's up. Thank you very much. Excellent presentation. Good. Now, Bamadev and Durga Prakash. Charita and Durga.
Will you buy this jewelry, Charita? Hi, Charita.
This jewelry?
No, I can't afford it.
Why?
Because it is too expensive. And it's very beyond my salary.
But when will you buy?
I want to buy it after 2 months, if I could.
Oh. Why could you take that much of time?
Because I would keep money for it so that I'll buy after 2 months. Do you like jewelry, Charita?
Yes, but I like very less. I show less interest to buy jewelry.
But why? They make you look good.
Oh, but I didn't like to buy jewelry.
Okay. Do your mother have any interest in that?
Do you like to buy jewelry?
No. But my mother likes to. No, but my mother wants me to wear that gold. But I don't like that. I say that, oh, why it is, I don't want to wear it like that.
Oh.
Yeah.
Prakash, small correction, and question, not correction. My mother wants me to wear, or wants me to wear whatever. Does your mother ask you to wear jewelry? You are a boy. Gold rings or chains, ornaments. Jewelry.
She wants me to. Oh, hello. Okay, sir. Jewelry means I meant gold, sir. Gold rings.
Hello.
Okay. So, finally, what's your status and conclusion? So, when will you buy jewelry?
After we get a job, sir.
Yes, sir.
No, after he got married, he would buy jewelry. Not for himself.
But it would be not for me, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. That was a fantastic conversation. Thank you very much, friends. Just let's take a look at the next one. Conversation 2. I'm just going to read it. Kindly take a look at this, listen to me, and you'll also have to follow the later. I'm pleased to talk to you. The pleasure is mine. I have heard Sumati speak about you often. Really? Wow, thanks. Where are you from? Vijayawada. Well, where are you from? Chennai. Bye. Okay, bye. Take 2 minutes to practice this. Your time starts now.
Where are you from?
Chennai.
Bye.
Okay, bye.
Uma ma'am and Sharita.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi, Sharita. I am pleased to talk to you.
The pleasure is mine.
I have heard Sumati speak about you often.
Really? Wow, thanks. Where are you from?
Vijayawada. Where are you from?
Chennai.
Bye.
Okay, bye.
Next, Charita Srikant Mishra. Ji.
Charita, I am pleased to talk to you.
The pleasure is mine. Mr. Sir?
Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Please speak.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Friendly helper for your presentation.
I have heard, you can present very well.
I know. Without any stop.
I have heard Sumati speak about you often, Charita.
Really? Wow. Thanks. Where are you from?
I am from Bareilly, UP. And where are you from?
I am from UP.
Okay. Bye.
Okay. Bye.
Now, Mishra and Uma ma'am. Friendly help will go away. Now.
Sir, I am pleased to talk to you.
The pleasure is mine.
I have heard Sumati speak about you often.
Really? Wow. Thanks. Where are you from?
Ranipet. Well, where are you from?
I am from Bareilly in Uttar Pradesh.
Okay,
bye.
Srikant Mishraji and Durga Prakash.
Durga Prakash ji. Hello.
Yes, sir.
I am pleased to talk to you, Durga Prasad ji.
The pleasure is mine, sir.
I have heard Sumati speak about you often.
Really? Wow, thanks. Where are you from, sir?
I am from Bareilly. Well, where are you from?
I'm from Andhra Pradesh.
Okay, bye.
Bye, sir. Okay, bye.
Charita and Durga Prakash.
Hi, Charita.
Hi. Hi, I am pleased to talk to you.
The pleasure is mine, Charita.
I heard Sumant.
Heard anakodadu.
I heard Sumati is often talk about you.
Really? Wow, thanks. Where are you from, Charita?
I'm from AP. Where are you from?
I'm from Tenali.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
Fantastic, friends. You have done a good job. This is really fantastic. Now, we are moving into the creative zone, which could be fun. So this is going to enhance our real conversational ability. Srikant Mishraji and Charita will be doing it. This is going to be the last session for today. It's past 9, okay? We can just wind up today's session. Please expand and mesmerize all the audiences with your conversation. Time starts. Over to Srikant Mishraji and Charita Samireddy. Turn on your video.
Yes,
hello. Hello, Charita.
I am pleased to talk with you, sir.
The pleasure is mine. The person who is in a good esteem to learn, so everybody wants to talk to that person. So you are learning very greatly. So please, and I have heard Sumati speak about you often.
Why, sir?
I have heard Sumati about you speak about you often.
Oh.
I don't know why she is speaking about you, but I think she was a friend of you.
Yes, sir. She is my friend.
Okay.
Sir, where are you from?
I am from Bareilly. And where Sumati lives?
Sumati lives in Vijayawada, sir.
Okay. Sumati lives in Vijayawada and I live in Bareilly. And you, where do you live?
I am from Vijayanagaram, sir.
Okay. Is Sumati your class fellow?
Yes, sir. She is my friend in my college.
Okay. In which class do you read?
PUC 1, sir.
I can't understand your class.
Time's up. Thank you so much. Conclude. Last 5 seconds.
Okay, sir.
It was nice talking to you.
It was nice talking to you. Glad to meet you.
Thank you. Bye.
Good. Excellent. Friends. Wow. Great presentation. It's Uma ma'am and Durga Prakash. You done
it. Hi, ma'am.
Time starts for both of you.
Hi, Durga. I am pleased to talk to you.
Ma'am, Adini, vaakyam ela cheppandi? Question mark ledhi actually akkada. I am pleased to talk to you.
I am pleased to talk to you.
Talk to you anakandi. I am pleased to talk to you. Meetho maatladu naaku aanandanga undi. Meetho maatladu naaku aanandanga undi anam kada?
Okay.
Aanandanga undi ante. So, I am pleased to talk to you.
Talk to you.
That's it. Yeah. Please start.
Please talk to you.
The pleasure is mine, ma'am. The pleasure is mine, ma'am.
Where are you from?
I'm from Tenali, ma'am. Where are you from, ma'am?
I am Ranipet.
Family member beside me, ma'am. He listened to you and he became a fan of you because you are really fantastic at English. Would you mind teaching him at your leisure time?
Your voice is not audible, Durga. Clearly.
Yes, it seems there is a technical problem.
Yeah.
From his end, network issue.
In which college do you study?
I study in RJUKT, ma'am.
Okay. Which subject do you like most?
I like maths, ma'am. In MPC, but I like to communicate very much, ma'am.
Okay, okay.
Especially in English, ma'am. What do you like, ma'am?
I like learning English and watching YouTube channels, in English YouTube channels.
Oh, very nice, ma'am. What are your habits, ma'am? What do you do in your leisure time?
My leisure time, my passion is cooking. I cook variety dishes.
Okay.
In leisure time, I read books. That's the good artist books.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, if you would have any job in this role, what would it be, ma'am?
Repeat.
If you could have any job in this world, what would it be? What do you like very much to do? What are you in much interested in any job, ma'am?
Okay, what are you much interested in?
Simply, which job do you like if you have to do any job?
Okay. Currently housewife too.
Okay. Would you like a leading, ma'am? Would you like leadership?
Leadership. Yeah, my school days, I am the leader in my school.
Oh.
Wow, how great.
Okay.
Right. Last 5 seconds. Please conclude.
Nice talking to you, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Nice talking.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Good night, ma'am.
Excellent. Friends, we are almost 9, it's 9, 7 or 8.
Let me just take leave things. Of you.
During that discussions, I have come across other shop, they give cheap. I think this is not meaningful. Other shop, yes, they give cheap. How can we express this? So, this is something that we have found. Other shop, they give cheap. So we can modify this sentence. How can we modify? Can anyone help me correct or frame a beautiful sentence? You could understand the sense which is expected to convey, but it did not actually have, when it was said, the required stuff. Other shop, they give cheap. We can buy the same kind of
jewelry
at, you can say, either less price, or we can buy the same kind of jewelry at the cheaper price, at the cheaper price. We can buy the same kind of jewelry at less price or at the cheaper price. In the other shop. And what is the other way to express the same idea? We might get it at less price. It's still possible. Which means, you mean in the other seller, not in at the other seller. Or merchant, gold merchant. You can also say, if it were elsewhere, if it were elsewhere, ide ganaka ekkadaina aithe, it would be much cheaper. If it were elsewhere, it would be much cheaper. You can express this in improbable condition.
Okay. But
this is the best model by using if clause. You can also say, by showing your surprise, oh my gosh, well, I can't afford, it's too expensive. See different ways to express the idea. Oh my gosh, wow, I can't afford, it's too expensive. You can also say, it wouldn't be possible for me to buy if it were that much. Here much, that much refers to that price. It wouldn't be possible for me, or it would be impossible, either impossible or wouldn't be possible. It wouldn't be possible for me to buy if it were that much. Okay. You can also say, perhaps I can try out in the other jewelry. These days people say not just a shop. Jewelry shops are big bungalows, big empires. So Kirti Lal and Kalyan, XYZ, say there are, yes, many things. So perhaps I can try out in the other J Mall, just jewelry mall. Or I can try at other merchant. Perhaps I can try out in the other mall. And you will say this, let me see. Still the seller or the one who gives you asks you to try or to just purchase, but you say, perhaps I can try out in the other J Mall, let me see. So if that is really expensive, I'll get back here. If that is feasible. Finally, the last expression, friends, I think this is too much, which usually we use, isn't it? I think this is too much. Where did I keep it? Somewhere it has gone. I think it is too much. You can also say, I think this is too much. So friends, like this, you can express various ideas. So you can take the screenshot, otherwise I'll give you PDF of this particular thing. I didn't like to buy. Another sentence said by Charita in today's session. If you give me 2 minutes, I'll explain. Otherwise you can take leave of the class. Would you want me to explain this next point, friends?
Please explain, sir.
Yeah. Here, Charita used, I didn't like to buy. How sometimes tenses mislead the communication when we don't use them properly. I didn't like to buy. This sentence is 100% correct. This sentence is 100% correct. I didn't like to buy. But what is the necessity, NMR? Why are you showing this here if it was correct? Context matters, friends. Something that you describe being part of your likes and dislikes comes under present simple tense. Present simple tense. According to this tense, we have to use subject plus V1 plus object. This is the structure. So what does it mean? We always have to use verb first form. Let me write here. For example, let us consider Charita's idea. Liking is the verb. Then, from her point of view, the sentence could be like this. I like to buy. This is how one can say. So this sentence comes under positive category. Positive sentence. Next. She really does not have any interest to buy. So how would she say, I don't like to buy? So this sentence comes under negative sentence category. Okay. This is the sentence which you have to look at for this. I didn't like to buy can be replaced by I don't like to buy. Because you never like it. You never like jewelry basically. But why? Even though this sentence is correct, why NMR, why are you saying that this sentence cannot be used? It cannot be used in the context of expressing your likes and dislikes or your interests. It was only used, it can be used only in the past tense. In the past tense, at one particular context. For instance, if Charita visited Tirupati, if she visited TTD, Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam, Lord Venkateshwara, if she wanted to buy something, though her mother asked her to buy one piece of jewelry, at that time particularly she did not have interest. Now if you ask her, Charita, you went to Tirupati, did you buy or purchase any jewelry? She can say this sentence. I didn't like to buy.
Oh, okay.
Because at the time, the models they displayed were not very nice. I did not get any interest to buy. So I did not like to buy. Which means, perhaps Charita can keep then here. Then refers to past tense, friends. I did not like to buy then. That's only one particular context. In the past tense, finished. So what is the takeaway? Please use didn't like or didn't plus V1 form to express something you did not do, you don't do in the past tense. That means you didn't like it, you didn't eat, you didn't buy, you didn't go, you didn't see, you didn't ask, you didn't just make a call. And quite contrary to that, please use don't. This is for likes and dislikes and something that you perform every day, every week, morning, evening, something you really perform, something you don't really perform. When you don't perform, when you want to express in the negative context, please use don't like. I don't like tea. That means you don't really drink it. What's the difference between I didn't like tea? I didn't like tea offered by my relatives, for instance. They did not make so tastily as much as my mother does. So my mom prepares tea well, it's so tasty, but I did not like it. There's difference from I don't like tea. I don't means I never drink. I did not like means I drink, but at that time I did not drink.
Oh, okay.
So didn't and don't, this is the difference you have to. Past tense and present tense, friends. And you can also say like this, and you have questions. In fact, do you like to buy? You make a question. It's actually positive question. PQ stands for positive question. And you can also make negative question. Don't you like to buy? It's negative question. These are the questions you have to develop, friends. To develop your communication effortlessly, you have to be thorough with these sentence models. And so you can make one or two WH type questions. Why do you like? For the reason, why do you like it? Why do you like to buy? Why do you like to buy? It's WH type question. WH type question. And you can also make another question. Why don't you like to buy? Well, it is WH type question. I will say WH type positive question. And here let's keep this way. Double H type.
Negative
question. Why don't you like to buy? We have money. Please buy it. Why do you like to buy? You have many jewelry items in our house. Why do you like to buy? So friends, let me stop here today with this being said. I think we can probably make a move. And we'll find the next session being to be interesting. And please join us same time. Till then, stay happy and healthy.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Good night.
Good night.
Thank you, sir.